Hey guys, Craig here. Fergie time, episode 6. Today is going to be a fun one. I'm in this little collaboration group. It's a bunch of us. We get together, we do funny reels, talk G parts, talk sponsorships, and just a bunch of stuff like that. The group's called the Mad Ghost High Fergie because there's four of us and it's each of our usernames. Hopefully you like the show. It's episode 6. YouTube, Spotify. Thanks, guys. Hey, Craig, Fergie time here. This is episode 6, and six episodes, and I have a fun show today. This is the Mad Ghost High Fergie group. This was the first real collab group I joined on Instagram, and we did some cool reels, and it was cool to meet some new friends and meet some new family. And we just kind of, everyone is cool in their own way. I'll throw their Instagram handles down there, but we got Anya with the cool yellow Jeep and Matt with the glow it flow. I got you.
There you go.
And then Jason, the ghost. Yeah, so we're just going to run through some questions and have some fun tonight. So the first one I got is, we'll start with Matt, and then just can each of you guys introduce yourselves, tell us a bit about your background and how you got into the Jeep community.
Well, my name's Matt, and my handle is madblue.jku. I got into the Jeep community after my Ford Focus, it was a hatchback, got totaled. It was decked out. I'd always wanted a Jeep, and I was like, screw it, now's the time to do it. And I got my settlement money from my car and jumped into the Jeep. And from that point on, I just went crazy with her and had some fun. Started designing out different things. I had a whole idea of what I wanted her to look like. And I found her online through an auction. And when
it's
she
JK,
came
right?
home, yeah, JKU.
What year?
My 2016. First okay. time having a Jeep. Something I've always wanted since I was a kid. I remember riding with my mom's cousin when I was like 8 or 9 years old. And he had TJ or something like that. And it was just riding around naked in that thing. I was like, this is the coolest thing I've ever done. And from that point on, I loved Jeeps, but just never had the opportunity to buy one at a you know, decent price. And boom, 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 here we go. And I got her riding around with Flo.
Yeah, my name is Jason, the Mojave Ghost. I got into Jeeps. My mom had a Golden Eagle when I was a kid, and we used to go out, trail ride, take the top off. I fell in love with Jeeps then. I bought a old Willys, 73 Willys when I was 16, and then that was my first Jeep of my own, and then I ended up with a 96 YJ that I had really built. And then I ended up with a 2000 TJ. Then I ended up with a 2008 JK. And now I own a 2022 JT.
Oh, well, my name is Anya, and my Jeep name is High Velocity. So how I got into Jeep industry, well, Jeep community in general, I grew up on the stage. I used to be a full-time show performer, and I started being working for social media and full-time social media content creator since 2016. However, back in 2019, I'm from Europe originally, then we moved to Boston, Massachusetts, and then 2019 we moved to South Carolina, and my show career completely stopped. However, I was still full-time content creator, and then I was really missing that excitement, you know, excitement from the stage and performances and all the show lights and everything. And then one of our good friends, Josh and his wife, Laura, they took me and my husband, Jeff, off-roading. And I'm like, I am really loving that. That's a lot of excitement. And I'm like, I have a very like wild nature. I love hiking, camping, adventure of all sorts. So I'm like, this is what I like. My Jeep is actually my second vehicle because I got my license at the age of 26. Because Ooh. I'm from Europe, so we don't really drive there. We like living in the city and we take public transportation. So I used to drive Acura MDX. And then I'm like, I want to get a Jeep because of all this excitement. So I got my High Velocity last June of 2023. Yeah, so that's how it all started. And I finally, like, after I stopped doing my show career, I was still doing social media thing, but I was really missing that excitement. So once I got the Jeep, that's when I went off-roading and meeting all these new people, and I started feeling all that excitement back, what was missing. It was a big chunk of me was taken away, and now it's back, and it's, I feel like it's even more, brings me more joy now.
Yeah, Jason, did you start this collab group?
Actually, yeah, but the thing is, though, is you're the one that started with the fun collabs. It was your idea that you came up with, like, hey, man, we should collab together and do something fun, and so I can't remember. I could probably go back and look, of course, but I can't remember the first one that we all did together.
I think it was a Seinfeld.
It was Seinfeld. You're exactly right. But no, for Craig, this was your idea. Now, the group chat thing is something that I was doing for quite a while before we started the collabs, for, like, to help out with engagement and just kind of network with people, and you get to know people a little better. But no, this was all you, Craig. So you're kind of a natural with this whole podcast collab thing.
So, Matt, what's some of your favorite sponsorships or partnerships that you've gotten so far?
My two favorite that I really enjoy, Op7 has been one that I've been sponsored with for a very long time. It goes back to my Focus days when I had my Ford Focus just decked out and all that kind of stuff.
So did you have all the underlighting and all that on the Ford Focus?
Yeah,
did it have halos? Or?
No, didn't have halos, but I had grill lights, I had underglow, I had the brake light. I mean, it was just decked out. She was a nice looking Focus, I ain't gonna lie. With Op7, they hooked me up, man. Great company. I loved working with them. Nancy over there at Op7 is the best. She's a sweetheart to work with. I've known her for years now, dealing with her. The other is Cosmo Tires. It's a family-run company that is amazing, and I just love it. We just got done doing an event over at the Ambush 2024 for Cosmo Tires.
So is it a Florida company?
Yeah, Miami-based. It's been owned in the family. It's a family-run business. They've been around basically since, I think it was, I want to say 1940, they've been in the business type of thing.
Wow.
And really, from generations down, and just starting to expand, they brought in Dom from Mickey Thompson, who is now part of the TGI Group and Tire Group International, along with Tony and them running things, and they're about ready to just blow up. I mean, they're coming out with all types of great new tires and everything, and I love the Mud Kicker. It's amazing. I'm happy with it. I can't ever complain about it. But the best part is that dealing with everybody at Cosmo is like dealing with family. I've been down there, I've met quite a few people there, and everybody is just amazing. And that makes such a world of difference when it comes to any type of sponsorships and people that you deal with. And that's who you stick with.
I have a lot, but you start with the...
Just your favorite. You can name a couple.
You're on the spot.
I have a lot of companies that I love, and the reason why I partnered with them because I had a specific build idea, and that's why I went with those specific companies. And obviously, because I had specific build idea, I love to work with those companies because of the parts and mods I have installed on, we have installed in High Velocity. But I guess I'll start with the X Comps tires, because obviously when you get a stock Jeep, and then that's like one of the first things you want to change. You're going to want to get lift and then you get tires. And so tires, this was one of my very first installs, and I went with the X Comps, and I am very, very happy with the quality, with this chunky, beefy look, you know. And they've been nothing but super supportive and just like great company to work with. And then I definitely have to mention my wheels, which is Anthem Off-Road. We went to G Beach, we were part of their booth trail build off-road. I am loving this company. I cannot really say much, but Anthem Wheels are coming out with something very, very exciting. So that's all I'm gonna say. I also will mention Apex Chassis. I am a proud member of Apex Army, the owner Chris and Catalina. It feels like family, you know, when you say that, you, like Matt mentioned, that, you know, working with Cosmos, it feels like being part of the member of the family. That's how it feels like, you know. I I don't know. I'm just really, really grateful for all of my partnerships.
What's some advice you can give to someone? Because you're getting the big time sponsors. Like, what's some advice you could give to people that are looking?
First of all, I have an idea with my build. So like I said, I have contacted some companies on my own. Some companies have reached out to me, and you know, unfortunately to some I had to say no because it just didn't fit my idea. And then to some companies I was more than grateful to accept the opportunity. And don't just be like, okay, I want this. Don't accept, even though all the opportunities may sound so tempting and stuff, but you don't want to go with like everything. You want to be very picky, specifically what you want for your Jeep. Two is that try to be as authentic yourself as you can, to make fun of myself. I love to goof around. I love social media. For me is the place to create, because I told you I'm no longer performing on the stage. So that social media right now is the place for me to express. But at the same time, I don't want to make my platform as like selling point. I don't want to be like, okay, so today I'm reviewing this product, tomorrow I'm reviewing this product, buy this, buy that. While me introducing the products and the companies I work with, I want to make it into a creative way, you know, even though I have some install videos, just straight install video, but then next post is going to be showcasing that product more in like in a fun, interactive and creative way. You know, truly love the companies and the products you work with, because you'll never be real on your reels and your pictures, whatever stories and the content you provide, if you don't feel the love and the passion to their company and to your Jeep.
But how did you get Anthem Wheels? Did they reach out to you? Or how about a company that you had to reach out? You don't even have to say their name. Just some random... some company that you had to go get. Like, did you show them your stats or your followers or demographics? Like, how did you sell yourself?
I think the main thing, when you like the company, like I said, when you truly like the company, you will show your support to that company. So, and the companies notice that. Don't just like send the message and be done with it. If you truly love the company, you will be supporting their pictures. You'll be supporting their reels. So I was constantly showing support to, you know, the companies that I currently work with, because I truly like them and I like their products.
Well, first, Novsight is awesome. Like, they've just been extremely awesome. And when the Halo first came out, I was just infatuated with it. You know, they gave me the Cyber Ones. They sent me a set of Cyber Ones. And then when I wanted to do the Halo, they were like, which ones do you want? Oh, obviously, I'm going to pick the 6-inch, you know. So how I do things is this. It's like a scratch my back, scratch your back type thing. So since they sent me the Cyber Ones and they sent me these 6-inch Halos, I went and I bought the 3-inch. And then I took a screenshot. That's how I do. And I sent it to them. They're like, hey, man, you bought those? I'm like, yeah, man, y'all help me out. I'm going to help you out. So I look at it as, I just got two set of lights. I'm going to buy a set. Recently, they just sent me 2-inch pods that are the amber and white that I'm going to replace on my knuckles. And so when they did that, I went and bought the 30-inch light bar. So we have a working relationship with one another. It's not always about what can I get. If a company is going to give me free product, then in return, if they have other stuff that I like, I'm going to buy something. It's kind of like buy one, get one. It's a BOGO thing for me. Apex has been, so I was kind of blown away with Apex, because y'all know that I have a pavement princess. She's real pretty. I don't like to get her dirty, but I want all the beefy stuff, right? So I reached out to Apex throughout my install, because I had some problems with the switch from Steer Smart to Apex. And he, like, this was a Saturday, like on Mother's Day weekend, and he like got right back with me. I'm a little different than Anya, because I wasn't going to say no to shit, nothing. You know what I mean? I was so hungry for someone to just say, look at his Jeep, let's give him something. I didn't give a shit what it was. You know, like, you know, these smaller companies wanted to give me these bullshit lights. Give them to me, baby. I'm going to Mac like they're the best lights on the market. You know what I'm saying? And honestly, here's how I feel. I feel like that the free stuff that I got that was garbage looked good on camera. It allowed me to get creative with my content and make good stuff. And then other companies like Novsight was like, dude, what kind of heights are those? I told them what kind of heights. They're like, ugh. You know what I mean? I'm like, yeah, right? So they're like, you need some good lights. And I was like, you know what? You're right. I need some good lights. So I went from not – I didn't turn nothing down. I'm just going to be straight up honest with you. Like when a company said, hey, we want to give you this. Bring it on, baby. I'll hook it up. I'll do my job and showcase your stuff. I'll floss it, put it out there. Talk about it, you know what I mean? The bigger sponsors started to come around. What I did was I started transitioning. I started swapping things out and getting better stuff.
If someone gave you something for free and it was crap and somebody asked you about it.
It's crap.
Would you be honest?
I'm honest, yeah.
It's crap.
It's crap.
Yeah, you got to be honest. You know,
I mean, and what I tell people that are, so there's.
But on your original post, are you saying it's crap?
Well, I mean, first of all, it takes a while to figure out if it is crap. Listen, I listened to Warpaint, and he was spot on with this, and he was saying exactly what Anya was saying. Like, if you're branding yourself out there as someone that people trust, if you're trying to sell crap to people, then you're going to end up being crap. So I completely agree with Anya 100%.
That's a good
point. I kind of went ass backwards with me. I just went backwards. I was that guy that got real caught up in the whole Instagram thing. Like, I wanted free stuff. I wanted sponsorship. We all evolve over time, and we all learn from our mistakes. My advice to people now is not the same as it would have been last year.
To chime in on your guys, both of your points, is the fact that if it's crap, it's crap. And I've basically, out of my bio, I've taken people out because I don't want to promote it. Just because, you know what, if people are going to get it because maybe I'm saying, oh, they're great, and then they see it on my bio, they're like, oh, man, Matt's running that. Let's try it out. And it's crap. No, like I've just replaced my headlights, and I've run into parts to where they're sending me stuff. People are sending me stuff, and I'm like, this is crap. Can I return it? They're like, well, can you do a reel of an install and put it up? I'm like, no, I'm not going to do it.
If someone posts a reel and you're like, ooh, that's pretty cool. I dig that. Do you trust that person's reel, or will you contact them directly? Or
I would hit them out directly.
Shoreline Off-Road. If everybody knows Maximus and Josh, Shoreline Off-Road started off as an apparel company, and he's transitioned into some badass equipment, bro. And I have to say, I've got a reel coming out. I've got some stuff that I've done, and his rock lights are no freaking joke, bro. They are no joke. Them things are heavy duty. They're made well. They're stupid bright, and they have four zones. So you got 8 set of lights, 2 over each wheel, and you can control each zone. So I can make each wheel a different color. I can make each wheel blink, flash, different colors. Dude, so I have to give a big shout out, but Shoreline Off-Road, he is not fooling around when it comes to rock lights. I replaced my Oracles with them. My Oracles I kept having trouble with.
Oh, wow.
My Oracle taillights, my Oracle headlights, my Oracle fog lights are perfect, but the rock lights are junk.
I think Josh put so much of his soul into that company. Yep. He's like one of the really good examples of the company owner who puts his entire self into his company. And yeah, I think he's great.
Know who you're giving your soul to when you're supporting someone, okay? Because when you give your heart and soul to someone and end up being assholes, it hurts.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. So know who,
I know, we know exactly what
you're
talking about.
Know who you're giving your time to, and because your time, let me explain something to you. I make decent money, and I don't want to work over. I don't want to come to work late. I want my time off. You cannot buy time. So when you're putting all your time and effort into a certain person or a certain company and they end up being garbage, you know, just pay attention to the red flags.
Is that why you're wearing a black rifle shirt?
That might be why I'm wearing. Hey, and let me explain something else to y'all. Hey, there's something coming up. Let's just say something is brewing.
So Matt, what's the coolest accessory you've gotten?
My favorite is the lights.
Yeah.
I like being able to take shots at night and glow up hardcore. So definitely Op 7's glow.
Op 7 is the shit.
It's something cool. You know what I mean? It brings me back to the day back when you're in high school, you know? I mean, I went to high school in the 90s, and you're looking at lowriders and all that kind of stuff with neon lights, and you're just like, yeah, I want that shit one day. And then now you got it. You know what I mean? It's like, yeah, I love my lights.
It took me 50 years to get it, but you know what I mean? You know, it's hard to say, man. Like I said, Shoreline Off-Road has got the best set of rock lights that I've seen, and I've had two sets on my Jeep. Op 7 at Nancy has been just completely awesome. Like, super awesome person. I love my underglows. And Novesight has been my go-to. You know, and I, you know, all three of those are lights. But, I mean, as far as, you know, listen, Ready Lift for the Mojave is an awesome lift. I support that wholeheartedly, 100%. And, of course, Apex. And Apex has just been jamming, bro. And I'm super stoked about my 2.5 polished aluminum, two and a half ton steering that I have, dude. I'm stoked with
tons,
it.
Not inches.
I'm stoked with it.
You're talking about accessories, accessories and mods, sometimes it's hard to choose. Just, I want to get a little emotional right here, but all of the accessories and mods that have been installed in High Velocity, honestly, I wouldn't have any of them installed if not for my partner shop, which is A2Z Customs, because they are literally taking the best care of my High Velocity Jeep, and they just transforming that little stock, I call it Jeep Bug, because it sounds like, you know, the 2.0 turbo sounds like bug sound. I call her Jeep Bug. They transforming her into a sexy beast, you know, because yeah. I'm telling you, all the work they have done to her, to this transformation, is all because of them.
What I've loved more than anything than the whole Instagram thing and getting followers and sponsors and stuff is just the connections that you make with certain people. Back when I'm 51 years old, and when we used to have like a Jeep meet, you would ride around and we'd staple them on telephone poles. You know, we didn't have social media. We didn't have all this. So social media has been a freaking awesome tool to like network. Cause like I can literally go to any state now and I can hit somebody up and be like, hey dude, I'm passing and meet up. Like people are like offering me a place to stay, want to take me out. Let's go have dinner. Like, so. You know, the whole Instagram thing, social network, and the whole Jeep community has been, it's been great.
You meet some really, really good friends, in this community. You really become really good friends.
I mean, and listen, this group right here, us four, dude, we've been like the four horsemen, bro. We've been going strong.
For the longest.
We have.
Forever.
Yeah, we've never had any beefs with one another. Blue. We've always supported one another. And look, we've all came a long way since we started chatting.
Let's go to the rapid fire question so we can wrap this up. All right, favorite time of the day?
Nighttime for me, because I am an owl, so I get all my energy after 9 p.m. and all of my ideas, and I like the peace and quiet. Well, I mean, I'm a social butterfly, so I like the communication with people, but also I like my peace and quiet time, and everybody goes to bed.
Morning time, right when I wake up and I'm having my coffee and it's peace and quiet. All I hear are the birds chirping in the morning and nobody else is up yet. And I get to just have my time.
Matt time.
Because the way I like, people always asking me in my reels, sunrise or sunset, I'm on the East Coast. The thing about the morning is like, if you wake up before daylight, nobody else is awake. The birds are not up. It's kind of like you have the world to yourself for a minute. So, and then the other thing too is if you sleep till noon or sleep late, your day's gone. So I like getting up early.
Sweet or savory?
Sweet. I always go with sweet. I love a sweet.
Anya's like, oh man, I don't know. I don't understand.
Well, I live on low carb, so I don't really eat like sweet stuff unless it's low carb and keto approved. So I guess, I mean, both. I'll say both.
No, I'm definitely sweet. Man, I can eat a whole dozen of donuts by myself.
Window or aisle? Think bus.
I'll say window.
I'll say window.
Yeah, window. I like this. I like the scenery and the clouds. And I can crawl over people to go to the bathroom.
Because I'm one of those people that likes to be able to react if shit goes down. So
I'm aisle all day. I'm aisle all day.
I think I have to say aisle. That's me. I have to go aisle.
No, same.
Although on a plane, I would love a window. But at the same point, I'll take aisle.
I'm in the aisle. I don't mind getting up for people, but I hate asking people to move.
Pet peeve.
Pet peeve. Oh, geez. Pet peeve is...
Anya got excited.
Holy
I'm so excited.
Crap, man. I've got so many different pet peeves that it's just... All right, one of my biggest pet peeves is driving on the road and people just turning lanes right in front of you without a blinker. Another pet peeve is somebody that walks up to you and just gets up in your face and starts talking to you right there. It's like, give me some personal space. You know what I mean? Another pet peeve is somebody that comes up and has bad breath and they're talking all up and all you can smell is their breath. Another pet peeve is I don't know. There's so many.
You have many. Oh, my goodness. My biggest pet peeve is toilet paper. There is only one way. There is only one way. We cannot be friends. If you hang the toilet paper the wrong way, there is only one way, which is this way. So when people hang the toilet paper like that, I'm literally like, I'm not going to touch your stuff at your house. I will change your freaking toilet paper if you put it this way. It has to hang like that. Whatever that's called.
Yeah, so, I get it. You gotta be able to pat it and pull.
And then my other big one is like, I am a very organized person, and I literally know everything, like where everything is. And I'm also big on sharing. I don't mind sharing. However, if you touch my stuff, put it back where it belongs. Like, I don't like when people come and touch my stuff and don't put it back. And obviously, you know, having a teenager in the house and having a husband in the house and like organizing the pantry, and then that freaking cereal box is not standing where the cereal box is supposed to be standing. I'm like, really? And I wasn't thinking about it, but like the blinking things, the lights, it's good point right there, Matt, right there. If you turn right or turn left, turn the freaking blinker. I mean, it's so easy.
They're out of blinker fluid.
I think a pet peeve would have to be, I can't stand to be lied to, man. I just, you know, I'm the kind of person that if you do me wrong or you don't like me or you just tell me crappy, just tell me and I can handle it. But when you kind of bullshit me or lie to me, I just can't deal with it.
Would you skydive if given a free pass?
Oh, hell yeah. All day long.
Yeah?
I'd do it. No question. I'd jump out of the plane. No problem.
What about you, Anya?
No, I'll fly in my dreams. I want my legs.
Yes. I'm scared of it, and that's the reason why I want to do it. So,
if you could time travel, which time period would you visit?
I would go in the past.
Anywhere.
When I was little.
Future, history.
Yeah.
I don't care.
No, I would go in the past when I was a little kid. One of my, because you know, I live in America now, and my family is in Europe right now. So I have a lot of, I feel a lot homesick. So I would totally go back when my grandparents were still alive and when I was traveling in the train with my parents during the summertime from my country, Belarus, to Ukraine. That's where we used to take summer break. Crimea back then was part of Ukraine. So, and one of my favorite memories is taking 2 days train travel, and I was sleeping on the top bunk bed, and I would have my little crossword book and my little Tetris, because we didn't have phones back then. And that's the time I would love. And then at nighttime, we would take stop. My mom would be sleeping, and me and my father would wake up. We would have a long stop in one of the Ukrainian cities, and we would just walk around the nighttime city. So that's like one of my best memories, and I would love to go back. And also fishing with my father. I love fishing with my father. So I would definitely go back in my childhood.
I would totally go back to the 1950s. I just think it's the coolest era of all time. It's got pure class. It's got great old school music. I think I would love the 1950s to grow up in that time frame. I just love the suit look, the hats, the whole thing, 40s, 50s, old speakeasies. I think that would be a time frame that I would love to go back to and experience.
Man, this is kind of, what's crazy to me is I probably would go back to the late 1800s, mid 1800s, man. I kind of like the idea of open range type stuff where you live off the land, shit like that. That's kind of where I'm at with it. But I was born and raised on a farm too, so.
If your life had a theme song, what song would it be?
Show Must Go On by Queen. That's like my number one favorite song for many reasons. I can, connect it to my previous show career, and then that ended, but Show Must Go On. I have a new life right now, new chapter, but also I live with very serious chronic illness, but I want to prove my body and my illness that show must go on. I should accept this challenge that I'm dealing with daily and just push through and enjoy the life and just keep going and just live life at its fullest.
I would go with the Eye of the Tiger from Rocky.
That's a good
one. Personally, I've been through so much different experiences in my life, from being a young little street guy to who I am today. And Eye of the Tiger, Rocky themes are just something that always motivate me and keep me moving forward. So I would definitely say Eye of the Tiger, because I just don't quit. No matter what the adversity is, whatever's facing me, I feel like I'm going to overcome it. I'm not going to stress about it one way or another. I might stress about it, but I'm gonna beat it. Whatever's thrown at me, I'm going to come over it. And the Eye of the Tiger hits me.
Cosmo Ties has a tiger as their mascot.
Ah, good point. That's a great point, Anya. Very
nice
true.
Plug. Nice very plug. True. I like it.
I like it.
Probably, I hate to say it, man, but it probably would be Fade to Black by Metallica. I don't know why.
Well, thanks, guys. I hope you had some fun.
Dude, great time. I loved it. Great time. Yeah. Thank you, Craig. It was such a great time hanging out. I enjoyed this, definitely.
That was fun. Bummer about Jason leaving us a little bit in the middle, having some technical difficulties, but he works on a boat. He's gone for multiple weeks at a time, so his time is very valuable. So I'm very grateful for what we did get with him. Hopefully you like the show. Check out everybody's handle on Instagram and just continue to like, subscribe, all that great stuff, guys. And if there's anybody you want me to interview or chat with, bring on the show, or if you want to come on the show, just send me a message and yeah, we'll make it happen. So thanks, guys. Appreciate you.